After trailing for 50 of the game's 60 minutes, Central Michigan stunned Western Michigan with 3 fourth-quarter touchdowns to steal a 35-28 road win at Waldo Stadium. A 77-yard touchdown pass from Shane Morris to fellow senior Corey Willis with 2:37 left in the fourth quarter gave the Chippewas their first lead, and they hung on to snap the Broncos' three-game series winning streak. Follow along for more on how CMU defeated WMU in the battle for the victory cannon. CMU highlights. Central's comeback started with a 29-yard run from Jonathan Ward, who broke a WMU tackle at the line of scrimmage, then wove through the Broncos' defense for a touchdown with 9:13 left in the fourth quarter. The Chippewas blocked a punt on the Broncos' ensuing possession, giving them the ball at the WMU 44-yard line, and three plays later, Shane Morris hit Eric Cooper for a 9-yard touchdown pass to tie the game at 28 with 5:50 left. Morris struck again with the long touchdown pass in the final minutes, but the Chippewas' defense was the star of the second half, holding WMU to 88 yards and 5 first downs after the break, while forcing 5 punts and a fumble. After logging 82 yards in the first half, CMU's offense exploded for 327 in the final 30 minutes, led by Jonathan Ward, who tallied 114 of his 132 yards in the second half. Morris finished with 243 yards on 12 of 30 passing for 2 touchdowns. His best work came in the second half, when he was 9 of 17 for 191 yards and the 2 scores. Corey Willis was Morris's favorite target, hauling in 5 passes for 148 yards and the game-winning touchdown. Defensively, safety Josh Cox led CMU with 9 tackles, while Nate Brisson Fast added 5 tackles and 2.5 sacks, while filling in for Joe Ostman, the Chippewas' defensive end and NCAA sack leader with 10. The win was John Bonamago's first since taking over the CMU program in 2015. Western Michigan highlights. The first half held the vast majority of the Broncos' highlights, and the offense was clicking thanks to another strong effort from senior Jarvian Franklin, who became the program's career touchdown leader in the first quarter. He tallied 157 yards and a score on 16 carries in the first half and finished with 228 and 2 touchdowns on 26 attempts for his third career 200-yard game, but he fumbled with 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter, which led to CMU's first of 3 scores in the final frame. Jamori Bogan added 53 yards and a touchdown on 9 carries, and Avon Tucker contributed 24 yards and a score on 5 attempts. Reese Goddard showed a strong running style and an ability to shake free from oncoming rushers, but his passing left much to be desired, although the persistent rain also played a role. He finished with 41 rushing yards on 11 carries with sacks removed, and he completed 6 of 18 passes for 42 yards and an interception. Derek Mitchell was a bright spot once again, landing 4 of his 9 punts inside the CMU 20-yard line, including 2 kicks that were muffed by the Chippewas' returners and recovered deep in opposition territory. Defensively, Malik Rucker led the way with 7 tackles and a pass breakup, although he was targeted on CMU's go-ahead touchdown. Caleb Bailey tallied 6 tackles, 1.5 for loss, but the WMU defense logged just 1 quarterback hurry and 1 sack, which came from Antonio Balabani. Key play. Shane Morris's 77-yard touchdown pass to Corey Willis with 2:37 left will go down as one of the rivalry's unforgettable moments, after Western Michigan looked in control through 3 quarters of the contest. The former University of Michigan quarterback lofted a pass right into the hands of a streaking Willis, who dashed 40 yards after the catch with WMU safety Malik Rucker trailing.